Welcome back to my channel. Today I want to talk about pirates. You might now think about fictional pirates like Jack Sparrow or Captain Hook, or maybe even historical pirates like Blackbeard or Störtebeker. But did you know that there in fact were female pirates? I mean, yeah, rather few, but they definitely earned a place in history. So let's talk about one of those famous female pirates, a real pirate of the Caribbean, the Irish pirate queen, Anne Bonny. For this story, we go back to the golden age of piracy. Anne's story starts around 1698 near Cork, probably in Kinsale, where she was born as Anne Cormac. We actually can't be that sure where and when she exactly was born, since records from back then are everything but complete. But what we do know is that she was the illegitimate daughter of William Cormac, a until then respectable and married lawyer. Her mother was one of Cormac's employees, Mary Brennan. Her father was desperate to conceal his, well, let's call it mistake, and tried to hide it by dressing Anne up as a boy, calling her Andy and telling everyone that Andy was a distant relative he wanted to teach so that Andy could become a lawyer himself one day. But all his efforts were in vain when his wife discovered the fraud and without further ado made the scandal public. His reputation was destroyed and Cormac separated from his wife, assumed custody of Anne and moved out of the little town where everyone knew of his infidelity. Cormac, Anne and her mother searched for a new start and moved to the British colonies in America, to Carolina, or more precisely to Charlestown, today known as Charleston, where they at first had a rough start. But Cormac's knowledge of law and his sales skills soon made it possible for the small family to purchase a townhouse and later a small plantation close to the town. Cormac became more wealthy and established himself as a merchant. Life was good for a while, but when Anne was only around 12 or 13 years old, she suddenly lost her mother to typhus. Her father started to set high expectations on her, for he wanted to marry her to a wealthy merchant before her 20th birthday, instead of watching his daughter hang around the harbor with poor sailors and pirates all day. But Anne, who had grown into a beautiful young lady with flaming red hair and emerald green eyes, had different plans. Anne met a lot of sailors in the harbor, but one stuck out to her, a part-time pirate by the name of James Bonny. Against her father's wishes, she married him in 1718 and got cast out by her father for that. Rumor has it that she took revenge on her father and burnt his plantation down, but we actually don't have evidence for that, so make up your own mind if this is true. Anyway, the newlyweds set sail to New Providence, today also known as Nassau on the Bahamas. Why there, you ask? Well, back then it was the capital of piracy and a sanctuary for pirates. If you were a pirate during the Golden Age, chances were you set foot on this land at least once. Bonny, the husband that is, began to work as an informant for Governor Woodes Rogers in 1718. So, while Anne grew fascinated with piracy, her husband brought fellow pirates to the gallows. Of course, that wasn't the best foundation for a marriage, and so Anne started to resent her husband. At the same time, she met John Rackham, also known as Calico Jack. The two fell in love, and, well, they would have married right away if there wasn't already a ring on Anne's finger. Calico Jack offered James Bonny to pay him so that Bonny would divorce Anne. This actually wasn't at all unusual in those times, but Bonny refused. Well, Anne left him anyway and started to work on a ship of Charles Wayne's, where Calico Jack already was a helmsman. Well, you might know that back in those times it was a superstition that a woman on board would bring bad luck, and so they weren't allowed on board most of the time. But Anne remembered childhood dressed up as a man, and started to work on the ship anyway. Of course, it was just a matter of time until someone on board learned of her secret. But instead of backing down, she took a stand and, well, freed the man who exposed her from his doubts and his life. Well, anyway, afterwards, no one doubted her right to be on the ship again. Her sailing abilities and her sword skills spoke for themselves. In the meantime, the pair and a dozen men got rid of Charles Vanes, the captain, and claimed the ship for themselves, starting to rob merchant ships near the coast of Jamaica under their own command. Well, the records are a bit vague from here on, so I can't really tell you when and where, but a new sailor joined the crew, Mark Reed, either on one of the raids or when they anchored again in New Providence. In any way, Mark Reed joined the crew. Why is that important? Well, Mark Reed was not just any ordinary pirate either. He, or better she, was also known as Mary Reed, and was the second pirate woman on board. Before I tell you how Anne's story goes on from here on, let's take a quick look at Mary Reed. She was born around 6085 as the daughter of an English sailor, who never came home from his first journey. Her mother put her into her dead brother's clothes from a young age on. So, just like Anne, she grew up more as a boy than a girl. With 13, she worked as a page for a rich French lady. But she left pretty soon to join a crew of a warship. She joined the army of London and quickly climbed ranks. During her time there, she fell in love with Sergeant Max Dudevant, revealed her gender to him, married him, and opened an inn in the Netherlands. But her happiness didn't last for long, since her husband died only 6 years later, in 1716. Then she decided to give up on her inn and joined the crew of a slave trader heading for the Caribbean. Well, it's possible that this ship was raided by Anne Bonny and Calico Jack, and that was the moment Mary Reed joined the couple, but we can't be entirely sure. Anyway, the couple became a trio, and Mary became the mistress of Calico Jack. It's even rumored that it was a love triangle, in the sense that the two women didn't only have a relationship with Jack, but also with one another. Anne Bonny and Mary Reed, the legendary lesbian pirate queen couple. But even though this seems to be common knowledge, there's actually no evidence the two women were a couple too. Anyway, at some point, Anne got pregnant with a son, most likely from Calico Jack. She gave birth to him in Cuba, surrounded by Calico Jack's family, and, well, left the child with them to resume her life on sea. The trio now sailed through the Caribbean, looting and murdering. As a team, they were notorious and widely feared. They stole a British ship and named it the Revenge. They hijacked several ships and soon became wanted by the government. They seemed to be unstoppable, until one day they were not. The governor of Jamaica managed to finally ambush the Revenge in October 1720. He and his English warships attacked the ship, on which most of the crew lay drunk on the deck, for they just had celebrated their successful raid of a Spanish galleon loaded with tons of gold. Nearly the whole crew, knowing they were in no state to fight, was hiding. Nearly. The only ones fighting were Anne Bonny and Mary Reed. They fought like lionesses, but they never had a chance in the first place. The whole crew was captured alive and brought to Spanish Town in Jamaica for trial. In November 1720, the judges declared the sentence for the crew. Every last man should be hanged to death. And yeah, the emphasis is on every man. For Bonny and Reed both claimed that they were pregnant, and therefore, by law, they couldn't be sentenced to death until they gave birth. Instead, they were sentenced to prison time until they would give birth, and to be judged again afterwards. On the 18th November of 1720, Calico Jack, and most likely most of his crew, were hanged. Jack's body was then displayed on the shores of a small island in Port Royal, Jamaica, as a deterrent. That island is today known as Rackham Cay. Legend has it that Anne's last words for him were, "If you had fought like a man, you weren't about to die like a dog." Well, sadly, Mary Read died just a few months later of fever. She was buried in April 1721, while Anne Bonny herself vanished into legend. There are actually quite a few theories what happened to her. One theory is that she gave birth in prison and then was hanged as well, or that she died during childbirth. Or maybe she was just released after childbirth. But some rumors say that she was able to contact her father, who, as you might remember, was a lawyer and a wealthy merchant. So maybe he had used his influences to free her, to let her come back to Charlestown, where she might have married a guy named Joseph Burley and spent the rest of her days with her children, and where she died as Anne Burley in 1782. I myself like to think that she was able to flee, raise her children, and live a free life of her own choosing. However, eventually Anne Bonny died, but her legend lived on. There is even a statue that was unveiled in 2020 in London, featuring Anne Bonny and Mary Read. Today, we can also find her in various books, games, and even on TV. For example, there is the series Black Sails, and the Netflix series The Lost Pirate Kingdom. She's also featured in Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag, in Uncharted 4, and is a playable character in Fate Grand Order. And anime fans might have seen her making an appearance in Detective Conan, Jolly Roger in the Deep Azure. And of course, there are several songs surrounding the legend of Anne Bonny, from which my personal favorite is the song Anne Bonny by Colleen, which I will link below in the info box and really recommend you to listen to it. But I think that's about everything I have to say to the legendary pirate queen Anne Bonny. Thank you for listening. I'll soon present another Irish pirate queen to you. Until then, leave a comment down below which historical son or daughter of Ireland or the British Isles in general you find fascinating. And as always, I would be very happy if you support my channel by leaving a like and subscribing. Coramil Morgat. Thanks a million. See you next time. Bye.